Captain has we're losing our bearings!
And cuts the wind!
Anchor!
Mains out! Let's go!
Acts like an officer!
Clues up! Laser sticks!
We're heading hard for land, sir!
Fire off!
Acts like an officer!
Wash away!
Get the mains free!
Full sail!
Old Billy Riley was a dancing master! Old Billy Riley!
Sir, why does England hate the French?
Who's for beer?
No! I got you!
Ah, Master Cormac. What you have learned from Le Chasseur was confirmed. The local lawbreakers are changing tactics.
What's their plan now?
Their boss has hired Benjamin Franklin to produce new weapons for them. He's very well guarded.
Benjamin Franklin? The scientist?
You have heard of him. Good. He is making equipment to spread gases among the populace. Toxic ones, as it turns out.
The populace? I thought they would use it against the authorities. Though that would be terrible as well.
The ruffians we have arrested refer to an intimidating woman. I believe she is behind these nefarious plans.
I look into this.
Thank you.
Hope. I pray it's not you.
What's Franklin working on?
Not sure.
But it sounds explosive. The boss really wants Franklin isolated. Oh, no one interrupts his work. Really?
Don't tell me it was the devil.
It is good to see you again. Your friend Hope said you were away.
I was. Sir, I've come to collect the results of your experiments.
Oh, well, it's a very good thing then. I just finished fixing the prototype. Here you go. I was preparing to leave for Philadelphia and then Europe. I was invited to lecture in London. Oh, would you be so kind as to inform Mistress Hope?
Of course. God, Hope. What are you doing with these felons? Turning the city against itself. What have you become?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
No. Yes, just old memories.
When I am issued new recruits burdened with regrets, I tell them the surest way to lose them is with gunpowder.
You're right, Colonel.
This prototype seems very powerful. Use it with care, Master Cormac. Our intelligence says this thing can destroy certain fortifications, as well as injure several enemies at once. There is also a more subtle way to use it. Some of these grenades contain a strong sedative. Fire one into the crowd and they will fall asleep immediately. We should test this new weapon. Use it against that door. Use these grenades to destroy that door. Good work. Good work. I think you are ready to turn this new weapon against the ruffians who would have used it. There is an abandoned factory nearby hiding a dangerous poison. Right now, it only causes sleep. But I fear those outlaws are distilling it. A more powerful formula could sicken or perhaps even kill.
And that's my first target.
Be careful, Master Cormac. We understand
all the better.
Mess with this. Maybe I can break the whole system.
Dangerous. promise you that.
Must get out, or I'm as good as dead.
The whole place will blow up!
Please, it's futile. You're on our territory.
What marvelous destruction, Captain. I saw the smoke all the way from the Morrigan.
That should discourage those miscreants. New York is safe for now.
With all due respect, Colonel, it's going to take more than a few explosions to get rid of this kind of trouble.
The boy is right, Colonel Monroe.
Shay, was it? Congratulations. You just burned a whole lot of rats out of New York. I'm Jack Weeks. This is William Johnson. I don't know about him, but I'm pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
It is, terribly dusty here. I'm sure Shay can recount his adventures to us over a pint. Hey, the first round's on, the Colonel, huh?
Is something the matter, Master Cormac?
Just a little confused. I must have breathed some of that gas.
Some ale will do you good. Come, we are all friends here. You will be taken care of.
From the Colonel.
Dear Master Cormac, my apologies for the brevity of this missive, but it is time we were honest with one another. You have demonstrated your loyalty and resourcefulness to the Templar cause, and this despite and perhaps because of your assassin origins. The manuscript the assassin sought has been in my possession for some time. I reclaimed it when my men found you marooned. The Grandmaster himself charged me to discover its meaning, a task I regret I have failed to complete. I leave it in your charge, Master Cormac. There is no one else I trust more. Now I leave for Fort William Henry, an ill-prepared garrison surrounded by hostile natives and the French army. We have requested reinforcements, but I doubt they will be forthcoming. I have no illusions that our resistance will be successful. I commit my life to the British Army, and my soul to the Father of Understanding. Yours, Colonel George Monroe.
Captain's helm!
Loose! A trip too! Mind your post, guest. The Colonel's in trouble.
How do you mean, in trouble?
He's at Fort William Henry, facing impossible odds.
Get off your lazy asses, lads, and man your stations! We raise anchor!
Sorry for the early libation, Captain. It has been a whole year since we met. A whole year! Changed my life, you did. And for the better. You will forgive me if I have been celebrating without you.
A whole year. Guest, I have a question for you. How long have you been former allegiance? Why didn't you say anything?
Well, the Colonel wanted us to avoid the subject so it wouldn't influence your decision making. You saved my life out of your selflessness. I made you an official 10 months ago.
Thank you.
me some...
Who is it up to, then? Monroe mentioned a Grand Master.
Oh, yes. The Grand Master of a colonial rite. You'd like him, Shay. His father was an assassin.
Really? He must have a story to tell.
What is the news from Fort William Henry?
Everything is surrounded, and reinforcements are late.
General Montcalm has been blazing a path across the colonies for King Louis, hasn't he?
I rather wish he'd stayed home with his mistress.
His or King Louis's?
Either. Though I suspect the King's is finer.
Indeed. Madame O'Murphy is supposed to be quite touched down.
And O'Murphy is in the French King's bed. Now I know you.
Thank you. Captain!
Let out some sail!
Unfurl, mate! Half sail!
As much sail as you can! Crowd on every end.
Could be valuable cargo.
For the colonies, for Frisco and for France. Well, the ship aboard the Limey Barton Hunts. And got legless drunk, come on.
It's the captain's ship! Let out some sail!
Come on, spread those sheets!
I think we cracked the spar!
Spread our wings to the wind!
Floating cargo for the taking, sir.
We're heading hard for land, sir.
Where's
our service? Take the shot, sir.
Mates!
Where are you,
anchor?
Shay, you are a sight for sore eyes.
Jack?
Colonel Monroe surrendered to General Montcalm. The French and their Abenaki allies took Fort Henry. Johnson was supposed to bring reinforcements here.
I don't see anyone else.
The Abenaki are restless. They don't understand the terms of surrender and refuse to heed Montcalm. The colonel and his men were released this morning. They're walking into an ambush.
Wait here in case Johnson arrives. I'll protect the colonel.
Thank you.
Maybe I can finally repay my debt to him. I hope I'm not too late.
Last of them.
Master Cormac.
Sir, we must hurry. We should bring what's left of your men to the Morrigan.
A welcome offer, Captain Cormac. Follow me. Safe passage is ahead.
If you don't mind me asking, what happened at Fort William Henry?
Poor planning and poor luck, I am afraid. Montcalm was able to bombard us for days.
Damn frog.
Actually, he acted with great honor. When we sent for Parley, he returned an offer far more generous than anticipated. We kept our arms, and more importantly, our colors.
Only to walk into a trap.
I would hardly expect the French to defend us. Would you?
No, I wouldn't.
You continue to prove your loyalty to the Templars, Master Cormac. Risking your life for me.
We're not out of the woods yet, Colonel. As for my loyalty, well, I do owe you, don't I? You saved my life. Gave me a second chance.
We have been working together for a year now. During that time, you have rendered many great services. Whatever debt you imagine you have towards me is paid, wouldn't you say?
Perhaps.
Yes, my lad.
You live! Attack! Take cover!
Keep together, men!
I'll take out as many as I can. Keep your men moving. I'll scout ahead and signal if there's trouble.
A sensible strategy. Very well. I will lead my men around slowly.
Yeah.
Kasegawase will not relent.
Kasegawase, you know this man, Master Cormac.
Aye, Colonel. He is one of Achilles' men. An assassin, as I was.
So they know I am Temple. And now this assassin knows you live.
And work with Templars. I'm no fool, Colonel. The assassins will come after me next. We're both targets now. You know that's a trap, right?
Indeed, Master Cormac. But we have little choice.
We survive the
French cannons, we will survive this.
I keep it sharp.
Get out of that!
I have as clear a shot as I can get.
Crow flies. I see him.
This way.
I can get him from here. You give up.
Come, follow me,
maggot. I've got a shot. Futile. You can't escape us.
Make haste.
Ship! Run! Run!
Yeah.
I have a clear shot!
Come, follow me.
Loose the sails!
You heard the captain, men! Let's get out of here! Move! Move!
Chain!
I owe you my life, Master Cormac.
As do I, Colonel.
We have much to discuss. However, I must tend to my troops.
Sir, I will accompany you to Johnson's trading post at Onokwaga.
Then I shall depart at once. Master Cormac, meet me there.
Loose, mate, sir! Get the mainsails!
Seasoned veterans among our ranks here.
You enough. You are a hero.
Let us see you.
Stop!
Your death is upon thee! If only he could stand still for a second! These guns are great! You one way or another! Mark my word! No! You fight him while I run away! If only he could stand still for a second!
Ah, good show, lads. We chased those criminals right up.
To be wrong.